Greetings, ladies and gentlemen, CCX here. Welcome to more Back Jack Daxter. Yeah, English is what am I doing? What in the world am I doing? Let's get out of the pause menu. Anyways, in the last episode, we entered the Precursor City and managed to complete it. But now in this episode, we're going to talk to these two fancy guys, which I always keep assuming that the camera kind of ends up changing their positions, but it really doesn't. So anyway, let's talk to this guy.
Oh, no, not another hero. I lost my shorts on this so-called hero's big fight against the monster up there. Trust me, the smart money's on the monster. That wager pretty much tapped me out. So, I got a proposal. Bring me 90 orbs to get me back on my feet and out of this barrel, and I'll give you a power cell in return. And if you're game, I do have one more bet online. My big comeback. Beat the record time racing Dead Man's Gorge in the Precursor Basin, and I'll get a pretty payoff. For that, I'll give you another power cell. Oh, yeah! These orbs will help me win my way back out of this barrel. Here's the power cell, I promise.
We don't question where he took that power cell, because that would be very, very vulgar. Anyways, we'll talk to that guy later, because that guy will not only give us a power cell, but he will also fix up the bridge. That's right, we need to pay for power cells to go ahead and fix up a damn bridge. It's actually kind of, it's kind of dumb.
You two look like a couple of capable fellows. I've got a research project going, and maybe you could help me out.
Hey, we're the ones on a big quest here. We asked you for help.
Well, perhaps we can help each other. I've been studying the burrowing habits of lightning moles in the Precursor Basin next to our village for years. But now those awful lurkers have scared the moles to the surface. And since they're blind as bats, they can't find their way back underground. If you could herd them back into their burrowing tunnels, you might just save their lives. I've got a power cell that says you can do it.
Yeah, lightning moles. We care. Maybe for two power cells.
Nice try. But I would be willing to part with another power cell if you two find me 90 Precursor orbs for my research equipment. Fair enough?
Sure, why not?
Oh, you have the orbs. Here's a power cell we agreed upon.
What do they even use the stupid Precursor orbs anyways? There's nothing to use them for. Unless they're using them for research and everything, which I highly doubt, but whatever. Anyways, funny enough, those holes that we've seen in the Precursor Basin are actually quite important. Except, even though when you think about it, if we didn't talk to her, those guys wouldn't be scattering all over the place. Oh, but they look so adorable! And there it goes. And just like that. They also make very odd roaring sounds, which I have no idea. I don't know. They sound like dinosaurs. I'm confused. The goal here is to just lead them into their holes and they'll go in automatically. You don't have to really do anything else. It's not really that complicated. Oh, you actually can hit them. I didn't know you can hit them. I thought they would just, Alright, hey. You, whatever, I don't know what you are. You look like a squirrel thing. Go inside your hole. They actually do have a set path of where they go before they actually head into their hole, so you do have to follow them for a while before they decide to go back and say, hey, I gotta go back in my hole because I feel like that I'm losing myself and all that other nonsense. Anywho, what the hell is that last one? I just ran into that like I didn't even care. Okay, well, oh, there it is. Hey, you little rat thing. Go inside your hole. You should be the last one.
Let's go get our power cell from the geologist.
Yep, that is our last one. But we won't get our power cell until we complete this very fancy race. This is a timer. This is a natural, normal time attack. Gotta beat that score up there, and you should be relatively fine. For this segment right here, once we actually get to it, you actually want to halt stop so you can go ahead and tightly turn, because funny enough, the game does not really tell you this. You gotta make that tight turn or else you're not gonna go ahead and win the race. Also, another thing I should mention is that you do have to jump on those guys to actually warrant yourself a very free jump. But, I don't know. I mean, to be honest, I beat the thing without even using, only using, like, what, one precursor, blue eco. So, yeah, the timer is not really that bad. The worst thing that can really happen to you is that you crash a bunch of times into the wall, and then you're like, damn, why am I playing this game? I suck at platforming. I should just stop and just go play games like Pong. Nah, I shouldn't say that. Pong is actually pretty good for its time. Anybody ever played Pong? I play like Pongs.
Thank you for saving those moles. That's awfully good of you. Here's a power cell to help you out. Now I can get back to my research.
So wait, we had to save a bunch of animals and you couldn't do your what the hell was that? The game just, like, it's just flashing all over the place. You know what? What the? Guys, have you seen this? I know I'm not the only one I've seen this flashing black, whatever. I'm just gonna ignore that and hopefully it won't go ahead and warrant me any problems.
Great moves, kid. I knew that time record would fall. Now here's your power cell, and I can go collect my big payoff.
Once again, don't question where those come from, because if you do, yeah. Anyways, let's talk to this muscle man here.
Of them all. I single-handedly defended this village from those horrid creatures for almost a year. Then that horrible monster arrived and commenced the boulder bombardment. So, full of valor, armor shining in the sun, I climbed the hill to take him on. But he pounded me like one tenderizes a Yakow steak.
Have you tried attacking him with your melodrama? Because it's killing me!
After my last stunning failure, he sealed the passageway to his roost with a 30-ton boulder, leaving no way for anyone to challenge him again. So, our sage, a master of blue eco, and a mechanical genius, devised a machine capable of lifting the boulder out of the way. But alas, he disappeared before we had a chance to turn. At least I was able to pull enough pontoons out of our bridge to prevent that monster from coming down here to do me harm.
Yeah, good job, tough guy. But we're gonna need you to put him back and stuff.
Oh, sure. And seal my doom? All right. Fine. Bring me 90 precursor orbs and I'll let the pontoons loose. But I'm not going to fight that monster again.
Oh, wonderful.
You brought me the precursor orbs. All right, I'll fix the bridge. But don't ask me to get involved with that creature again.
All right, now you guys are probably wondering, what is the point of fixing this bridge? Well, for one, if you try to swim in the water, which is very possible, by the way, a lurker shark would come up and eat you. But to be honest, though, with the way how the platforms are segmented, you can really relatively make your way through this bridge without the lurker shark really eating you, which means that giving him the 90 precursor orbs is a bit of a waste, but if you don't look into that, you'll be relatively fine. Oh, we actually got 100% in Rock Village. Okay, no, we don't. We don't have 100%. I lied, guys. We actually missed one scout frog. Seriously? I wonder what that. Oh, I actually know what that one is. That one's just back at the Blue Sage's hut, because this is gonna be not the last one. Anyway, it's time to go to the Boggy Swamp. Now, if you do talk to Samos, he ends up mentioning that there are, well, those things that we need to go ahead and stop. Those are the Lurker's blimps. We need to stop those things because, well, those things are pretty terrible. We got ourselves some new eco here, Yellow Eco, which essentially powers our abilities by giving us some, well, think of it as this game's this fire flower. That's kind of the best thing I can go ahead and give it, like, the best analogy, similarities I can tell you is that it's literally like the friggin' fire flower from Mario. It's ridiculous. But funny enough, Yellow Eco does not return. The only Eco that returns in Jack, well actually no, none of the Ecos return. And I didn't think about it. Well, Green Eco kinda returns, because it technically is considered your life force at this point, but it's not really that great. Also another thing, when you are you need to power up. When you are powered up with Yellow Eco, what you could do is you can stand in, you can not only just stand on the Yellow Eco, you can also end up going first person, so you can be able to shoot anywhere. Because if you end up doing it normally, Jack will only just shoot the Yellow Eco from the ground, which is not really that effective. So yeah, and the Boggy Swamp is, well, for a place that's called a Boggy Swamp, you actually cannot go ahead and touch the swamp at all, because if you do touch the swamp, you get electrocuted. Why do you get electrocuted? I don't know. I actually don't really know why you get electrocuted. It actually does not make any sense, but, well, and there I go, and I'm out. And Boggy Swamp also has a very wonderful checkpoint system too, as I demonstrated there. To be honest, I don't like the checkpoint system. It's stupid. Anyways, the thing about this area that makes it a bit annoying in terms of progression is that there is a lot of precursor cells and things. I kind of just combine them both together because why not? You can actually make it over here, and you don't really have to come over here. This pathway is only for people who are coming back. And I'm just gonna kill all these things. I mean, I probably really shouldn't, because I don't really have the ability to. But I'm gonna take this pathway instead. I mean, you don't have to, because of the fact that this is coming back from the entrance. But, whatever. Actually, you know what? That's a damn good point. I'm wasting my time. Let me just die.
I'll say something really teary at the funeral. Like, how am I gonna get changed back now?
Alright. So, let's go to this place proper this time. The enemy layout for this area is not really that bad. You got some brambles here, which are, well, they are indeed the hurt. And the most important mission is to not only use the Flutflut, which will come back in this segment. It's the second time. Well, not the second time. The first time that you'll be using the Flutflut. There is another time where you'll be using it. At least I think that you'll be using it again. I'm not entirely sure. I know in this area you'll use it because it is technically important. And I also don't think that you really have to destroy those mushroom things, because I don't think you get anything for it. But I will go out of my way to destroy them because, well, they need to be destroyed and they are in the way. And they're pretty much just on the way, you know. They have to be destroyed. I just power myself up. Blast here from a distance, because if you keep killing the rats, they will just keep coming back, which is very lovely in terms of respawning. Hey, at least it gives you your actual reason. That's kind of something that I like about in Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild, which I have been playing non-stop as of late, because obviously, I mean, I've been playing too much Breath of the Wild. I don't even know how to freaking platform anymore. That's lovely. Wow, that's sad. Oh, thank God. The checkpoint is just right here after getting killed by that frog. Almost made it sound like that. It almost made it feel like it never happened. Also, I think since those things respawn, that kind of ends up indicating that it really does not matter. But I don't really know, because I don't really... whatever. I'm just going to shoot from here. Yeah, that gotta love that programming right there, where the Yellow Eco just kind of defies all logic altogether. It's great. I love it. Anyways, we jump here, and we get our very first Okay, go away, please. I don't like this level. I really, really don't. Alright, there was really no point in coming here except for a friggin' scout fly. That's great. I love it when the game gives me, like, no sort of reason to come over here. Like, really. And jump. Alright. For this segment here, we just want to go ahead and just go on a first-person view and just keep shooting the wonderful yellow eco. Charge ourselves some blue eco so we can match the... Thanks, Daxter. Like, seriously. You're a good bro. Nah, I'm kidding. Daxter's actually pretty cool. Daxter is actually a really, everybody actually really love, Daxter and Jack's dynamic. Especially, it's a lot better in the second game because, well, instead of Jack being a complete mute, he actually, you know, plays off of Daxter entirely. Now, I'm not entirely sure how you guys feel about that. I mean, I know for, like, Legend of Zelda case, nobody really likes Link talking because, well, Link is technically the character. It is technically you. But, like, what the, like, what in the world, what kind of games do you guys don't like your characters talking? And how do you guys feel about when it comes to, like, protagonists not having, like, no sense of voice at all? Except for the occasional yes, no, and what are you doing? Like, sir, I guess it really also depends on the game, too. Like, if my character doesn't really know how to emote, especially if they, you know, really... really focus so much on the whole emoting thing when it comes to a video game, then I kind of do have a bit of a problem with it. Like, you need to emote, man. You need to emote. If you do not emote, then I don't know what your problem is. Go away, you stupid frog. And there's, like, a lot of games that tend to do that with a silent protagonist. Like, I mean, Chrono is fine, even though, to be honest, I can forgive Chrono being a mute only because of the fact that in the animated cutscenes that they give you for the PS1 version and DS port, they actually really emote him properly, even though when they emote him, he kind of reminds me of a Dragon Ball Z character, which I think that was probably the case. And, you know, with Link, he also emotes as well, depending on which Link you're playing as. Like, if you're playing as Skyward Sword Link, he emotes. If you're playing as Twilight Princess, he emotes. If you play as Wind Waker, he emotes. It's like, rarely most Links will always emote. Not all of them, however, sadly. Like, I mean, the original Legend of Zelda, Ocarina, and Majora, he doesn't he gives no craps to anybody, alright? Like, he really just does not care. It's just like, he just wants to be in this adventure. It's like, yeah, whatever. I don't care, guys. I really don't. Wow. Only two more tethers. But I mean, you know, I kind of understand graphical... Well, no, not really. No, I don't understand. Because to be perfectly honest, he emoted when he ended up seeing Twin Rova combined together. I mean, I would too, seeing like two freaking old ladies combined into one sexy MILF or JILF. You know, there's an actual word for that. Like, there's a literal word for that, and it's G-I-L-F. I don't... Really? What the fuck is wrong with you people? It's like, what the hell is wrong with you people? I don't. Why? Why? World's weird.
You live in this world, man.
Yeah, that's great. And that's the problem. I live in this world. So I have to literally be forced to question it. And I, god damn it, I would question it every single bit of logic as I can. Anyways, in this segment here, well, you actually are not supposed to do this. You're supposed to use the flut to be able to go ahead and cross all this, but. Pro strats everywhere, man. I mean, hell, you give me a long jump, I'm gonna use it. Okay, I won't use it. All right, I'll get off. God damn. Ugh. That's ridiculous. Anyways, we won't have to go in that section. Not yet, anyways. What we're looking for is we're looking for the Flufflet. Okay, this here is... What is the point of this? Like, what is over here? This is just randomly here. It's like there was supposed to be a level here, but the designers just gave up. Like, I don't understand. I don't get that. Like, there are occasional games that end up having, like, design choices, and they don't utilize it until, like, the next game or another game that they end up working on. I like to believe that that's like a homage to stuff. Go away, you dumb rats. All right. By the way, I love how when you... I love how when you die in those water segments, Jack makes the gargling noises like he died or something. Anyways, we need to look for that Flufflet. Because I can't get through this level without the goddamn thing, you know? I really can't. Go away, you random lurker bats, or whatever the hell you guys are. If you go near where the lurker bats are, what happens is they kind of swoop down and dive bomb you, which is lovely. And can I just say, the word dive bomb, I really don't like that word anymore. Well, I mean, if you guys play Final Fantasy 14 and, you know, when they end up, like, literally spamming monsters, it's only the dragons and sometimes the occasional, monster that has the... Oh, that was dumb. I mean, what the hell you thought was gonna happen? We're gonna jump on this platform, and when we jump on this platform, we'll have ourselves another fighting gauntlet. Okay, this is not the Finding Gauntlet. I thought this was it. Oh, no. It's the other platform. There's the game. And going. Right back. Yeah, that platform right over there. Oh. Huh. I actually never noticed that. If you actually look at the, well, the only way you can see it is if you are jumping from it. But it actually shows an arrow. I never knew that. Huh, I thought that was just a lightning bolt. That's something I never really noticed. I never noticed that it shows a freaking arrow symbol. So that's how much I'm never paying attention, right? I mean, am I right? Yeah, I'm right. Go away. I shall beat you all with my hands of destiny. Look at me, I'm a Dragon Ball Z character using Ki Blast that... are the equivalent of an actual fist. Seriously, what the... Why the hell do we have Ki Blast that don't do anything anymore? Kind of really says a lot that Dragon Ball is a little bit better in terms of the fighting, because Dragon Ball Z goes on way too long. I mean, you guys can love your Dragon Balls and whatever, but to be honest, I much really prefer... okay, I know how... Well, that's going to be coming out once we gotten rid of all the segments. But, yeah. Dragon Ball, you know, in terms of the story, like, it's still stupid and ridiculous. But I can literally almost say that it kind of keeps with its plot a little bit better. There's the Flufflet, you little chicken bastard. Anyways, the Flufflet has the capabilities of not giving you any defense. I know, you think that you having a Flufflet will go ahead and give you any defense. No, it's not a chocobo, guys. Even though I kind of wish it was. So what kind of chocobo is this? Is it like the blue chocobo? Yeah, I think it's the blue chocobo. Seriously, I love like different rendition themes of the chocobo theme. Like, I think if I have to pick my favorite one, I like, well, in terms of rating of my top favorites, I like, well, it seems like the cops don't really want me to go ahead and actually tell you guys my favorite, because, okay, yeah, I am immune to the bog. Anyways, I like Final Fantasy VII's battle version of it. I mean, I also like the one that plays when you're fighting. Wow, you can shoot any slower. Okay, forget it. Then that kind of really just proves to me that there's really no point in destroying those things now. Alright, I'm still alive. What the? Okay. I accidentally hit the thorns. That's great. And I'm just gonna blow myself up again. Alright, you know what? I'm gonna just do this flut segment and then I'm gonna just end episode. Unless I die again, I'll just end the episode prematurely because reasons. What the? Alright, I'm ending the episode now. Alright, guys. I'll see you guys in the next episode where we continue more into the Boggy Swamp. I really hate this level. See you guys next time. We'll be right back.